Hello, my loves. It's great to be here with you again. And today we have a Saturday video, which means we are doing video on relaxation. Remember, we have Tuesdays, fizz exercises like toning and understanding how muscles work. Then we have a Thursday video, which is all skincare. And the Saturday video was about to be meditation video and relaxation video and so on. And then I understood that it's very important to dedicate at least one video to manual techniques of relaxation. And in this video, I will be showing you how to use your hand to manually relax your face and a tendon helmet. For this particular exercise, you're gonna need a table, and that's why I brought one in here, because we're gonna be putting our elbows on the table and relaxing our face manually. So if you guys are interested in this kind of videos, then please stick with me till the end, because we're gonna be learning. My loves, new format of the video. We're going to be manually relaxing and elongating muscles on our face, and most importantly on the tendon helmet. Basically, the tightness and the lift of our face is mostly attached to the tendon helmet. And if tendon helmet lost the separation between bone and the fascia and the skin and stuck to the bone, there is no blood circulation in there, and face start to literally droop on our bone. So it's extremely important for us to know how to work with tendon helmet, how to release the attachment of a tendon helmet to the bone, and that way we are going to put face where it belongs, build the blood circulation, provide the oxygen supply to our head, and overall rejuvenating our appearance. In addition to the fact that you're gonna see the difference right away, it's a very relaxing practice. So we're gonna go right ahead and start our today's exercise. Very quickly before I go to the exercise, very often estheticians, I think younger estheticians, they write to me and they ask, what is the most important thing in a facial when you do lifting facial, because this is what I'm mostly specialized in. And I'm gonna answer, you know, I usually type in personal messages, but I'm gonna quickly answer in case you have the same question. It's a work with tendon helmet. If you work only with face alone, no matter what gadget you use, unless it's a fillers or Botox or actual facelift, it's gonna droop very quickly back together. But if you're gonna put your hands in a tendon helmet, relax tendon helmet, put it where it belongs, you're gonna see how much longer the effect of the facial that you provide customer with will last on the customer. In fact, you can ask them, for how long did you see your face being lifted? And they will tell you at least 4 weeks, they're gonna see some kind of unusual lift on the face. So working on a facelift facial without working with a tendon helmet is not gonna provide as good a result. However, I understand that it's a quite a labor intensive work, and of course you cannot book as many customers because your hands get tired. But if you really want to produce facials that last and really want to leave the face so your customer will be like, wow, you know, before and after, they go straight inside, release attachment of its skin to tendon helmet first, then go on the face, and you will see how much better results are going to be. So that was a quickly for my fellow estheticians, and now for all of us. So as always, before we do any exercise, we need to warm up ourselves just to get the blood circulation going. We're gonna do our regular thing. 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, both hands, 1, 2, 3, 4, both shoulders, that was 1, 2, 3, 4. And we're gonna go to my favorite exercise, and that's shortening of the tendons and the muscles on the neck. When you compress them together, the stretching them becomes so much easier. So we're not going to spend too much time on it today. We're just going to do very, very little bit. Be very careful with your neck. If you have any neck issues, do to the best of your ability. So for example, if you come up to here and that's what feels comfortable and coming closer is uncomfortable, stay where you are and work within your comfortable zone. Over time, everything is going to stretch naturally. So the next thing we're gonna do, and that's why I brought table in here today, I'm not using any creams because I like a really good stretch. However, my skin is very, very lubricated to begin with. So if you're not used to this kind of method, I would highly encourage you to wash your hands, wash your face, and use a cream moisturizer. You can use nourishing cream if your skin is dry. You can even use oil, but non-comedogenic oil, of course, which I would go for a grapeseed oil because we know for a fact you're not gonna break out from it. I need you to put your elbows on a table. So this is going to give you leverage. Put your hands together and put your hands straight on the two sides of your nose. And then this is the trick. I need you to, with the weight of your head, push through your hands while you slide your hands sideways. Go as far as you can. In this point, I need you to bring your head down. Now, don't forget your elbows are on the table. And bring your hands back on your neck. Remember, the whole time your hands are on table. In my case, they are not, otherwise you're not gonna see me. It's very important for me to see you, for you to see me. However, you will have to do it. You will have to hold your hands on the table the whole time. So you're sliding, that you're pressing against your fingers while fingers are sliding. And as you went to the end of the hairline, you bring in your arms back and you're putting them together behind your head. It gives you beautiful drainage and also it stretches the muscles back there where they belong. The second thing we are going to do, we're going to put our whole face, the fingers are going as if they are combs, into the brows. Now we're going to start right in here and we're going to go into the tendon helmet. And we're pressing head against your fingers and we're going into the tendon helmet as far as we can. I'm bringing the hands back. I didn't know if you see me, so I'm gonna do it again. Now you're gonna do it while your elbows are resting on a table. For a purpose of your visibility of me, I'm gonna do it without my elbows resting on the table. We're standing on, right on top of the brows. We're going backwards. Stretch, 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 and going down, down, down. Meanwhile, you're pressing your head against the fingers and you're bringing your fingers backwards. Stay there, go sideways. Now you're gonna do the same thing on the sides. Press your head against your fingers. The heaviness of your head has to go against your fingers. Press your fingers into your tendon helmet and go upwards. Now, you can absolutely do it the way I'm doing it right now. And the only reason I'm telling you to use the table, because it's actually easier for you to have that kind of leverage in front of you when you're doing this exercise. However, if you feel that you're stressed, if you feel like you're somewhere that you not necessarily have a table next to you, but you feel that your muscles are contracted because in favorable situation, because you have to wait for something, or you're just stressed, put your hands inside and start pressing against your tendon helmet quite strongly and collect your hands together. That gives you incredible stretch, an incredible elongation of the muscle and the stress relief. The next thing I want you to do, I want you to come very close to the hairline, wherever your hairline is. Mine is quite high. put your fingers right the hairline. In this case, I would like you to wipe your hands because you need a good grip. And if you're gonna have a lot of oil, you're not gonna be able to have a grip. I need you to grab it and start pulling that part upwards as you wanna stretch it into your hairline. With one hand. And you can do with the other if your hand feels tired. So basically by the hairline, you're dragging everything upwards. You can also go inwards that way. So basically we take the muscles and going in. Especially if you guys have lines on the forehead, it's extremely helpful stretching techniques for the line. We do other exercises for the forehead, but the whole idea is to strengthen muscle, meanwhile, to elongate it. If we're not gonna elongate muscle and put it back where it was once was, back where it belongs, we're not gonna able to see the lift we want to see. And the only reason we are doing these exercises is to actually see the lift. So today I've showed you a very easy practice. Again, you can use the leverage or you can just go with your own hands into the tendon helmets, but make sure that you're really pressing against your skull because it is definitely going to help you with lifting, with bring the blood circulation and oxygen into the skull. Now, I got this idea for all the girls. I know what's happening. You guys are purchasing my basic exercise system, and basic exercise system works that you purchase and it stays with you. You're on your own. I'm always, when I'm sending you the email, thank you for purchase, I'm always asking you, please reach out to me because I want to be in touch with you so I could guide you. Very few of you reaches out to me when you purchase basic exercise system. Intermediate and advanced are easier because we do it in a bootcamp way, so I really look after you. But the basic, so you could learn basics, you just purchase it and it stays with you and you work out by yourselves. Well, I decided that I'm going to do a group on a Facebook, most likely I will announce where I want all of you guys who have basic exercise system to join that group, because I think that if we're gonna all be together and if you're gonna get to know each other and if you're gonna share your experiences, it will be easier for you and for me to keep you motivated and keep you doing the exercises, because they work as magic, but they need to be practiced. If they're not gonna be practiced, they're not gonna work. However, if you're gonna stick with the system, you're gonna see a great result. And in my opinion and in my experience, when you have your fellow facial exercise practitioners, ageless beauty practicing ladies, and one gentleman actually, with yourself, then you can communicate, you can share your experiences, you can share maybe other things between each other. Ask me questions collectively, or maybe I'm gonna answer question to one of you that the other is gonna be interested in. And then it's gonna come to you, oh, I wanted to ask that too. So I will be announcing, and I'm not gonna be able to trace everybody who got the system. It's quite impossible for me, but you know who you are. And please, you know, reach out to me and tell me I want to join a group, and I will definitely send you an invitation so we're all gonna come together and we're gonna be there together. However, if you're not practicing basic exercise system, I will leave the link underneath the video. However, if you choose not to do it, you have so much of a material straight on my platform, whether it's Instagram or it's YouTube. I would highly recommend you to refer to that material, because it can do magic to the way you look and feel. Today was, as I told you, Saturday's video. Saturday videos are usually very easy, very light, and this one was on relaxation. Now, as far as stretching goes, please don't push yourself too hard to stretch. It's not gonna work to your favor because you're gonna overstrain your muscle and you're actually gonna be uncomfortable. Everything within the comfort zone, within the comfort feeling, and then you can give it another 10% on top of it to give a little bit of extra stretch. Don't forget to stretch your neck, chest, shoulders, face. By face, I mean going, as I told you, in a tendon helmet every single day. Facial exercises, as far as plumping, you can do 3 times a week because you want to have time in between. However, things like stretching that and the posture exercises should be practiced pretty much daily. As far as massage goes, if you have time to do it daily, it will be great. Soon enough, the new bootcamp is going to come out where you're going to have the whole day written out for you, what goes after what. But before we started our bootcamp, please, as I told you, stretching daily, posture daily, facial exercises on plumping 3 times a week, and massage hopefully 3 times a week plus, as much as your time will allow you, and you're gonna see big, beautiful difference in the way you look and feel. I hope today's video was entertaining and I hope it brought you value. It's not resultful yet. In fact, I have to tell you, nothing from facial exercises is resultful until you practice it. And as soon as you start practicing it, within a couple of weeks, you'll be like, wow, that really, really works. I promise it works. Just do it. As always, if you like this video, please give me a thumbs up. Please hit the subscribe button and notification bell next to it so you could get notified every time new video comes out. If you have any questions, please write them underneath the video. And as always, thank you so much for your time, for your attention, and I will see you all in the next video.